Hi everyone, how are you? Well, this is Coins Kid. Just going to dive into Bitcoin. Big up the Coins Kid crew. Thank you for following me on Twitter. Thank you for your Patreon. I wish I could meet you all in the street and buy you all a beer. We should organise a beach party at the end of all this, eh? Or sell and go to the beach. Meet on there and just have a good time. And then buy in the bear markets. Remember, billionaires are made in bear markets. So stick with the channel. I'll always show you where the lows are, okay? So right now, Bitcoin is doing okay. I'm anticipating some kind of ABC correction right here. But you're holding the support right now of this. Look, there's all sorts at play here for Bitcoin, honestly. Trend lines and, there's loads of support and resistance at play. So basically, look where you are now. Look where you're finding support, okay? Look, when you came up here, you made a low. Just there, you find support. That's where you are right now. You know, you're here. You know, where you was in February. You know, you're right there where you was in February. And if you can bounce here, you're looking at continuation. But I'm anticipating, you know, Elliott Wave structure. I think that we're going for Elliott Wave theory, basically. And we're looking at a Wave 1 high, a Wave 2 pullback, wherever it comes back to, Wave 3 extension, Wave 4 correction, and Wave 5, you know, for the continuation of the bull right here, okay? So it's looking good, you know, there's all sorts at play. So I'm going to show you what I see, okay? So right now, look, you create this broadening channel. Do you see this broadening channel? You've broke it, okay? When you broke it and you've got extended, where have you found support of the channel? Do you understand that? So that's relatively bullish. You've broken out of a broadening channel, okay, and you're now back testing it as support. So providing you can hold this as support, you could bounce here and get continuation. But the only thing is, if you do start to lose this low just here, you're falling back into this broadening channel, aren't you? Okay, and if you was to start to lose this green trend line, this way you could come down and create a lower low just here, and potentially, you know, you're rolling, aren't you, like that. Do you see that? So, and effectively, you know, just looking at it like that, that's a double top, you're rolling, descending triangle. It's all about this support down here, which I've told you. If you start to come down in, you lose this support, that's really negative for Bitcoin because you are going to roll. But I don't anticipate that. I think that Bitcoin is really, really bullish. I think it's gearing up for its sort of last leg, basically. You know, I think it's playing out as it played out before, because look, we came down a massive falling wedge. We've already broken it. So our destination is, you know, retracing to where we formed the highs in the wedge. Do you understand that? Just like this falling wedge here, look, boom, 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 boom. I gave you all your targets. They were all met to the T, look, boom. Absolutely fantastic, okay? So you are still within this wedge, and you could come all the way as low, as I've told you this. If you lose this support here, you come all the way as low as this wedge and bounce off it and still be bullish, because all you're doing is back testing the former resistance as support for continuation. So do anticipate that this is a play as well. You know, you could see a deeper roll here, and this could coincide with this sort of ABC correction look. So you've got wave two coming, A, B, you know, a false high, and then a deeper C wave down to there, retest as support, okay, if you lose this low just here. Because I'll show you where this has happened before, okay, look, just here. Anticipating, I think I've shown you before actually, so you know you're doing exactly what you've done before. It's uncanny, okay? So look, wave one high, wave two low, wave three high, wave four low, okay? Right now we're breaking out wave five. To validate it, we have to break this high, okay? So to validate the ABC structures done within here, we have to break this high. For me, it's looking like it is done, but I could be completely wrong. But what you're doing right here is something that you've done before, okay? Came down in a falling wedge, you've broken out just here, broken out that level of resistance, and in doing so you created a rising wedge just there, okay? Boom, 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 rising wedge, fell back to where you created the wedge. Do you see that? So you got the test of support just there, but when you came back up to make the high, you rolled back to the trend line of the large falling wedge just there for support. But at that point you lost it because of the corona dump. Okay, do you see that? So, you know, you're going through something very, very, very similar here for Bitcoin up here, you know, where you've fallen down in this falling wedge like this. Look, bum, 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 bum. Broken resistance, coming back up. You made a rising wedge. You've come back to where you formed the wedge. And right now you are holding that as support. But if you do start to see that loss of support, there is a potential here that you could come back down to where you know the trend line test as support once more. If it gets that nasty, you know, if you start to lose this low which I've given you, okay, do anticipate that this trend line will come into play as a key level of support. So you might get fortunate enough, but again, it's all if you lose support. I'm trying to show you that, yeah, every scenario here, okay? You know, if you lose support, you've got to go short, okay, and target previous levels of support on the way down that were resistance. You understand that, yeah? Basic technical analysis, you know. So yeah, it is playing out very, very similar, you know, in this correction over here, you know, with the RSI, the waveforms, everything, the wave counts as well, which I've shown you in previous updates. So just here, you know, you've potentially got your A, your B, and you see there, and you should have continued, you should have got support off this trend line, back testing a former level of resistance as support, look, because you melted through, you came up, got overextended, and you fell back to its support. At that point, we had the corona, unforeseeable black swan event, you know, a capitulation event, but immediately after, Bitcoin was bought up because it was that strong, okay? The markets were that strong. It's not just Bitcoin, everything, S&P 500, the whole lot, you know, the gold, everything just got bought up massively because it was in a major bull market. So unless we have a black swan again, I don't see that sort of capitulation. I could be completely wrong. No, it could be part of the cycle, couldn't it? This could be the ABC correction within that, but I don't see it playing out like that, because the world was in despair, you know. Just here, it's not really in despair, is it? Unless we've got another virus that is locking everything up again, you know. I think that this, when the whole world went into kind of lockdown, wasn't it, you know, and everyone had to start social distancing and all that kind of rubbish. Unless we have that again, I don't see it. I think that we're adhering to Elliott theory, we're adhering to structure like a boss, and potentially a retest of this trend line here could actually be in play for Bitcoin. It might be a bit of a cheat sheet for you. So yeah, do anticipate, if you start to come any lower here than this low that you've put in for yourself, this could be a potential play right here, okay? So again, I'll give you all your targets as and when they come, you know? So if you lose support, go short. Break resistance, go long, basically. So yeah, it's playing out. And I think that once we get this sort of wave two correction out of the way, because I am anticipating that something like this is at play here. Look, we've got the one high, the wave two, wherever it is, the wave three high to 107k or wherever it is, say roughly around there, and then the four wave, and then the fifth final wave to 200k. This is what I'm seeing. Until we sort of roll over and lose this structure here, then you know, this is what I'm seeing, basically. So yeah, that's Bitcoin. You know, do expect, if we can sort of rally here, we might put in a B high, okay? So it'll be a low higher than this. So you sort of some kind of rally up here, put in a lower high than this one, and then we'll have another rug pull down here, you know, and wherever the low is. I'm going to try and find this low for you. And this is if it does happen. Obviously, it doesn't have to happen, but it's sort of gearing up for it, I think. And just here, this is a low that I've given you at 3,800, isn't it? 38,000, sorry. You know, because this kind of makes sense, because this is a mini version of what's happened before. Look, so... if you've not watched the video from yesterday, I'll show you high, low, and then you got extended and you came back to where you from that low, just there. That's why I was able to give you that bang on, yeah? And just here, you know, you are forming something very, very similar. But if this C wave correction gets quite complex, then do anticipate that this trend line will come into play as it did in the previous wave two correction. So just here, you've come up, you've made a high, you've made a low, you've got overextended, and you're rolling back for support. Now, this is a primary target for me at 3,800. But if you do start to see a bit of a capitulation event, a bit of a scam wick, you know, potentially you could come all the way to that trend line, okay? You understand that, yeah? So that's basically Bitcoin. Hope I've been transparent with you enough, as I hope you understand what I'm saying there. But it is all what ifs, isn't it, you know? So if you do start to see, because I did say to you, September, rectember, yeah, I did say that to you, you know, historically September last 4 years has been very dumpy. Now if you do start to see something like this, a bounce here, and it puts in a lower low, and you start to roll again, then you've got your targets, that and that, okay? If you see that lost at 3,800, there's your trend line that you'll see it bounce off. And again, full transparency, if you start to come down and lose that, you're looking at coming lower than this, and you're rolling, okay? And you've got a massive, massive correction on your hands here for Bitcoin, and it is the end of the bull market, you know. But I don't anticipate that, because you're doing structure, you're looking for continuation, you're coming back for support, and it's all good, basically, until you lose support. That's Bitcoin. Hope you enjoyed that update. Stay healthy, stay strong. And just straight off the bat, you know, like I said, the deeper you retrace, the greater the impulsive pace. So, for example, if we was to come all the way down to this low just here, you know, you could be looking at a beautiful 65k on the next impulsive. But if we was to come all the way down to this trend line, wherever it is, 35k or something like that, if we did come all the way down there, I mean, your next impulsive is a 69k. You're really getting the party started there, aren't you? So yeah, remember, the greater you retrace, the greater the impulsive pace. Retrace to a key level support, you're looking great for continuation. And I think down there, the golden ratio is down there, isn't it? Yeah, the golden ratio, the fib retracement, the 0.618, is down there around about, yeah, 35-36k, isn't it? So possible. So yeah, that's Bitcoin. Hope you enjoyed that update. Stay healthy, stay strong, stay tuned. Take care, bye-bye.